boss up. This is Blaster Boofing, and the video I'm covering today is special to me. Well, most videos that I cover are. But there is something very special to note about this one. You see, I'm working on a series going over Maryland's Pokemon Emerald Nuzlocke, which I hope to get complete within a few years. Anyway, earlier this year he made a video announcing his retirement from making YouTube videos. And since I want to talk about that video, as Maryland means a lot to me, I decided to do just that. So, without further ado, let's dive in!
How's it going, everyone? Maryland here!
I will never get tired of that intro. Sadly, I think I'm gonna hear it for the very last time. From new videos anyway, I'm sure I will hear it a shit ton more times when I analyze the rest of the episodes of Maryland's Emerald Nuzlocke series. Which, again, I'm working on a series going over on his series on that.
After nearly 14 years on YouTube, I think it is time for me to step back and stop making content for my main channel.
Well, I certainly will miss you, Barry. I have been subscribed to your channel since 2007. I discovered you before I discovered the Angry Video Game Nerd and the Irate Gamer, which is weird since they were far more popular back then. But anyway, yeah, you were one of the first YouTubers which I watched regularly, who I still watch even to this day. Your videos were great, but it's totally understandable that you wanna leave. Take care, pal. I will miss you.
First, let me just say, in these 14 years, almost 14 years, I mean, I started technically my channel in 2006. I didn't really start doing videos until... oh, what was it? I think it was actually maybe very late 2006 or very early 2007.
As for me, I first discovered you in 2007. And I don't recall seeing any videos you made before that on your channel back then. So I can confirm that you made your first public videos in 2007. From what I can remember anyway, my memory might be a bit foggy.
For the Japanese version of Pokemon Diamond and Pearl,
honestly, I don't think having a Japanese version of a Pokemon game early is really that much of an accomplishment. I mean, you could easily fucking buy them online and pre-order the games that way. Hell, you can even pay extra to get it home from the internet early. And since it's something that literally anybody can do, as long as they have a credit card, having a Japanese version early is really not much of an accomplishment at all. Oh, and it was also that way back in 2007, when I assume you got it.
You know, so many people, they get into YouTube nowadays because that's something they've seen other people do.
Oh, that's definitely the case with me. Since I saw so many fucking people make videos, I decided to make videos on my own. Though I did plagiarize in the past, which I regret. Thankfully, I don't do that anymore, and now only make videos with my own unique style.
I hated my voice. I absolutely hated it back then.
Honestly, that's very irrational. You shouldn't hate something that's out of your control. We don't get to decide how our voices are like. We are born with it. And there's a reason why I delete all comments where people are mocking my voice. Because those ASOs who do that are not worth my time. Your voice is nothing to be ashamed of. Neither are any other things that you can't fucking control. Just be proud of it. Only a fucking moron would care if someone's voice is good or not.
You know, it had amassed 100,000 subscribers back when, you know, that was... shoot, that'd be like the equivalent of 5 million nowadays, I feel.
Now, I have been on YouTube since 2006, and I can tell you from experience that what Marant is saying here is absolutely correct. Having 10,000 subscribers was a big deal back then. In fact, back then, there was no one with million subscribers. That didn't happen until 2009, when Fred was the first one to receive that milestone. Hell, back in 2006 and 2007, there were very few YouTubers who even had 100,000 subscribers. That was a big milestone back then that was extremely rare. Things sure have changed a lot since then. Now, getting million subscribers is still a big deal even to this day, since most YouTubers don't have that, or hell, even 1,000. But it was literally fucking impossible back then, that's what I'm saying.
In 2011, that is when my channel was the target of false DMCA attacks, as was several other channels.
Oh yeah, I remember that happening a lot in the past. That is unfortunately the reason why there is another critic had to leave YouTube back during the early years of the site to upload his content on his own website. That is the reason why the Channel Awesome website was made to begin with. I mean, sure, nowadays there is a Channel Awesome YouTube channel, but back then there wasn't. And the only reason you could have found Nostalgia Critic episodes uploaded on YouTube back then is because a lot of his fans re-uploaded the episodes to YouTube. And thank goodness for that. Because if it wasn't for them, those videos would probably still be gone from YouTube. Now, the broken copyright system has gotten better since then, but unfortunately, it still has flaws that need to be worked out. Even though most of the times when I dispute a claim, it goes through and my videos no longer are blocked worldwide, there are some times when it's declined, even though it clearly falls under fair use. The stubborn assholes who decline it are completely in the wrong, completely, and they don't understand fair use at all.
Back then, there weren't really clear guidelines if that was allowed or not. It was gray area.
I can tell you for a fact that it was allowed. Usually rules on websites only tell us what we are not allowed to do. And if it doesn't say in the rules that you aren't allowed to do something, you are obviously allowed to fucking do it. That is common sense. Look, no one was breaking any of the rules when they made those videos. The only reason those videos got taken down is because of the broken flagging system. And again, even though it has gotten better, there are still many problems.
It was something that, you know, you couldn't really fight. You technically were breaking their rules.
I mean, you are right at the first part, but there is something that I need to know. What the hell rules are you referring to? Because I was an active YouTuber back then, and I don't remember any rules prohibiting that. I would love a sword for your claim, because I don't believe it at all.
I saved the channel, but I lost all the videos in the process. And those were never fully restored. I did re-upload them, but they weren't ever restored, which is sad to see that part of history gone. But, you know, it is what it is.
I mean, at least you got to restore some of them. A lot of videos that were once available on YouTube are long gone. Especially from the commentary community that I'm a part of. Hell, speaking of long gone videos, not just some, but all of the videos that I made before late 2008 are now long gone. Even though I'm not proud of the videos I made back then, it still fucking sucks that I can't find them anymore. Because I would love to look back to see how fucking terrible they are. I would love to analyze them for my third channel, but nevertheless, I fucking can't. And that's something that I'm gonna have to deal with.
Now, thankfully in 2012, I did manage to become a partner through Curse.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, back then, being a YouTube partner was a fucking privilege. Only a very few people got accepted in the partnership program back then. Now, the Angry Video Game Nerd, despite his hard work, didn't get accepted back then. I mean, he does get paid for his videos now, but back during the early years, he didn't. But you know who did get paid by the YouTube partnership program during the early years of YouTube? The Irate Gamer. Look, I totally stand by that the hate he got back in 2007 was uncalled for. But it is bizarre how someone who isn't liked by the YouTube community got the partnership program over someone who was well liked back then. Now, of course, later on, anyone could become a YouTube partner. But unfortunately, that's not the case anymore. Nowadays, you can get demonetized for the most ridiculous reasons ever, or no reason at all. Which is why getting paid by YouTube is not worth it anymore. The dream of getting rich off making YouTube videos is all in the past. Which doesn't really bother me, since I do have a full-time job now, which I go to every morning.
And they also opened the door for monetization, which was really a wild concept, because that had been something I hadn't done.
Anybody who thinks that making videos is easy is a fucking moron. Although it is true that anyone can make a video, not everyone can make great videos. It takes talent, dedication, and a lot of hard work. And not to mention it takes a lot of effort. So anyone who thinks making a great video is easy clearly don't know what the hell they're talking about.
And, oh, that's interesting. This guy stops while I'm sitting down. I don't know what to make of that. That's kind of interesting.
All right, I will admit that is an improvement over the older games. Now, I haven't played Pokemon Sword or Shield myself, since I am not as passionate about Pokemon as I used to be. But this is still very fucking interesting.
But anyway, that was something very impactful. I know a lot of people fondly remember the Emerald Nuzlocke and the HeartGold Wedlock that I did for my channel.
Oh, I don't just remember it. I am now analyzing your Emerald Nuzlocke series. And I have to say, I'm not far into the series yet, but from where I am, it's still a fucking awesome series and holds up extremely well. Which is why analyzing the series is hell of a lot of fun for me.
People would turn to ROM hacks or randomizers and all this other kind of crazy stuff. And hey, you know what? That's fine. I understand. I know it can be sometimes entertaining to watch. But the thing is, the policy I've always had on my channel, I always play on the actual legitimate versions of the game. Like, I don't use ROMs. I don't use emulators. I'm not changing my stance on that. And I refuse to. I didn't want to compromise my beliefs. Now, if you do that, hey, that's fine. You know, I'm not trying to tell you how to live your life. I'm just saying that's not something I was interested in doing. I don't want to do anything that could promote piracy.
Honestly, that's something that I always admired about this channel. I was never a big fan of randomizers to begin with. They were a fucking mess, since they were so fucking confusing, since literally anything could have happened. That was not fun to watch at all. And it is rare to see a Pokemon YouTuber playing a game completely legitimately. And your channel was unique in that regard, and that's something I can respect about you.
And on top of that, I know that I have been rather poor as far as handling criticism in the past. This isn't something that, you know, I'm really looking to defend. I'll fully admit, I'm not the best when it comes to that. Not everyone is. And although I've definitely grown a lot over the years, it's something that I still struggle with.
Honestly, it's completely fine that you are not good at taking criticism and still aren't. Most people on the internet aren't good at taking criticism. It is sad, but I don't hold it against them, since it's normal.
And I apologize if I ever snapped at you in the past due to a comment you made. I apologize if I may have not been the most mature over the past, well, I mean, it's been, what? Almost 9 years I've been doing those types of challenges.
Although you admit that you're not good at taking criticism, at least you're mature when admitting your faults. And that's something I can respect about you for sure.
I wanted to be clear that my intention at the time was to use it as a way to provide content for you more regularly. I thought by maintaining a schedule and by recording and using the footage I took from there, so then I would have content for you on a regular basis, I thought that would work out well.
Honestly, that's not a good way of thinking. You should never aim on making videos as frequently as possible. The term quality over quantity exists for a reason, because it's true. I'd rather have someone upload a video once a month of great quality than have someone upload a video on a frequent basis in poor quality. If you upload videos frequently that are not edited at all, or any of that, it will do you more harm than good. And it's also never a good idea to rush things. Trust me, I've learned that from personal experience.
I don't ask you guys for likes.
Which is something that a lot of YouTubers, quite frankly, need to keep in fucking mind. I never say in my videos, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, since I trust my audience to be smart enough to do it on their own terms, and they are. I always had an issue with people asking for stuff like that instead of earning it. And the fact that you never did is something that I can respect about you for sure.
The reality is, I've lost subscribers since the Sun Nuzlocke, since 2017.
That doesn't necessarily mean that you're doing anything wrong. Losing subscribers and views on your videos is normal. It happens to everybody. Hell, a lot of YouTubers who used to get millions of views on their videos don't even break fucking 50,000 views. But that doesn't mean that they're doing anything wrong. It just means that they are losing relevance. And there's nothing wrong with that, since, like I said, it's normal.
Every single attempt I have made over the past few years, the past few years now, has been relatively minimally received.
Look, I understand why this is bothering you. I really do. But making something fresh with a lot of people and you watching is an incredibly difficult task. Hell, I've tried for years to get a video which I will not name to lose relevance, but some fucking morons out there refuse to allow it to become irrelevant. But of course that doesn't mean I'm doing anything wrong. Hell no. I'm still making content that some people who watch me enjoy. And that's all what really should matter by the end of the day. You can't please everyone. And attempting to make videos that pleases your audience in general is usually not a good idea.
And I apologize in advance if it hurts to hear this, because it's never fun hearing, you know, one of your favorite creators, or maybe just someone you started watching, I don't know, but I stop and I think of YouTube, and it's almost always been something I've done for other people. I've done it for the viewers. I've done it really for them. Do I get happiness from YouTube? No.
Now we'll give you credit, for despite not having fun making videos, you did it regardless, since people enjoyed them. That is admirable for sure, since it shows that you care about your fans. And honestly, if you don't have fun anymore, there's no fucking point in continuing. Because having fun with life is the most important aspect of life. I know this is an unpopular opinion, but I don't think money is the most important thing in life. So a lot of money does not bring happiness. Having fun with life is. So whatever you decide to do in the future, good luck with that, pal. I will be there to support you. And I hope you find something that you genuinely enjoy doing.
I don't. And it's sad to say that, but it isn't something that makes me happy. It's something that has eroded a lot of my sanity over the nearly decade and a half now, well over a decade.
It doesn't really hurt to hear this, but it is very concerning. Honestly, if that's how you really feel about making videos, you should have made that decision a lot fucking sooner. It's not healthy to focus on something that damages you mentally. It does more harm than good. Your mental health is far more important entertaining an audience.
I keep trying to do a video like that, or a series like that, and time again, it just doesn't work. It's just not, it's not there. And I think a big part of it is, back then, I could play the game in Japanese. I could write it out, write out a walkthrough, a guide for it, and then it would be released in English a few months later. So I'd already know everything, and I'd already have all the resources available. That changed with X and Y.
Honestly, I would argue that getting the game in Japanese isn't much of an accomplishment. Literally fucking everybody can go on Amazon and eBay and buy the game in Japanese there and have it sent to their home. And it's not just the case now. I know for a fact it was very fucking possible back in 2007 when you made your Let's Play of Pokemon Diamond, originally.
I wasn't even going to. Honestly, I'm gonna be real, I probably just finish the series out of spite, just to shut people up.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that's a fucking terrible reason to do that. You should never rush anything. After all, a rushed product is a shitty product. And also, it makes you look like an asshole, it really does.
Wrong reason for a creator to do things, but that was how I was pushed.
Well, at least you acknowledge you were in the wrong. I will give you credit for that.
It doesn't bring me happiness anymore. It I don't think it has. Like, I stop and I think of all these moments, and I'm glad that it brought you joy. I want that to be really clear. That's why I did it. But it's not something that really brought me fulfillment.
Thank you, and I really appreciate you entertaining people over the years despite not enjoying it. That shows some real fucking dedication.
My videos will still remain here for you all to watch. I have no intention of taking them down.
And I fucking thank you for that. I am in the middle of making a series analyzing your Emerald Nuzlocke. And I can't download all the episodes of that series, obviously, since my computer doesn't have enough space to hold them all. So I will continue the series until I'm done. The only way I will stop is if YouTube gets shut down one day. Let's all hope that never happens. Because there are unfortunately thousands of videos that are only available on YouTube and are not re-uploaded anywhere else.
hopefully it's something that helped bring you a lot of joy and a lot of smiles along the way. Hopefully it was something that you found enjoyable.
Oh, it sure as hell did. I had a lot of fun with a lot of your fucking videos which you made in the past. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. It really is sad to see a YouTuber that I've loved since close to when I started on YouTube retire from video making. But I totally respect his decision though and wish him the best of luck on whatever he has planned for in the future. I discovered Maryland before I discovered the Angry Video Game Nerd, the Arid Gamer, or hell, even the Amazing Atheist. He was one of the first YouTubers I ever watched. And I will never forget how fucking awesome his original Pokemon Diamond Let's Play was. It was hell of a lot of fun. So goodbye, Maryland. I sure as hell will miss you. But at the same time though, I totally respect your choice. That's all I gotta say, people. Thank you for watching and have a great day.